Now, buddy, right in front of us, we have got a very special 777, a very large 777. This one's got a wingspan now of 71 meters, which is something feet higher wingspan than, for example, the 747-8 has. The biggest 747. The wingspan here is so high that we can't even properly park here, you know, in between these two 737s. We've got a big problem that Boeing, of course, solved when we go into the crappy old 2D cockpit. We can just pull this special lever right here. And then, oh yes, everybody, this is of course not a normal 777 that's flying around today just yet. Of course, we're talking about the unreleased 777X project that is still not on the market today, but we have it for the XPlane flight simulator. And just like that, we can park perfectly well with a reduced wingspan by almost 7 meters. That is very good. Everybody, welcome aboard the 777X indeed. Yes, a while ago, it made its first flight in 2020. Here we go, rollout lounge in 2019. Check this out, the largest 777 ever made. In fact, the largest twin jet. Largest twin jet in the world. But this plane was set to be already flying by 2019, but obviously that was delayed. Yes, there were some technical difficulties, especially with the brand new GE9X engine. Oh yeah, look at that beautiful piece of engineering. You wouldn't want to get sucked into that one. Like, check out all the people here. Yes, indeed, the current state of right now on the 777X is that in November 2020, it was revealed that GE9X engine on one of the four tests 777 suffered a technical issue, so the test program was paused. Maybe they're going to bring out the new 777X in 2025. I mean, it's got a proper order history. Airlines do want it, and people want to fly on it. In today's video, I would like to experiment around with that, especially here with the folding wingtips. Those are so interesting. I mean, they basically look like glorified winglets. Check this out. And for this, of course, again, we have this new add-on that kind of sucks. Here it is, the 9X incomplete pre-release version. We can tell that. I mean, the cabin, for example, is see-through, even though we cannot find Sam Chewie in here. And of course, the cockpit, as you've already seen, is like this very standard X-Plane 2D cockpit that absolutely sucks. In real life, the 777X kind of looks like the 787. In general, this plane will be very much like the 787, because that is just such a modern and great airplane, also from the cabin. Really, really amazing things. So, buddy, here we are at the ramp of Innsbruck. Fitting nicely in between here. There we go. Y'all, you can see how important it was to cut down on that, you know, wingspan with the wing tilts. I mean, we talked about the 747-8 issues recently. You know, that big boy can't fly to many airports at all. Severely limited because it is a bit bigger than the older 747s. Anyway, it's time to fly. But of course, not with the normal wingspan, the good wingspan. We're of course going to reduce that. Yeah. Okay, that looks great. I think right now here in this model, you know, the wingspan will actually be simulated, which is great. Something we don't have is the shadows, which is a bit strange. But let's come on, let's take off here from Innsbruck Airport, an airport that maybe in the future could hold the 777X. Although there's probably no demand for it, but let's take off anyway. The beautiful GE9X, these huge engines right now are spooling up to 100%. This plane seriously has some power to it. Jesus Christ, maybe put the flaps down. I just wanted to know, like, how does this plane fly with the wingtips up? I'm guessing it'll be a situation like just having normal winglets, and that's kind of the case here. Oh, I think we might have done a tail strike. Okay, yeah, this plane does need a whole lot more runway than it probably should. There you go, we can nicely put the landing gear up. And yes, despite the wingtips being out, we're perfectly flying. In real life, I would kind of doubt the structural durability now. Probably, you know, if we're to fly very fast, these things will just break off here. Yes, they're held together here pretty well. This is kind of nicely modeled. I like that. Let's put the flaps up too, and here we go. We are climbing, but not very much. We might just genuinely want to put these wingtips back to normal. Yeah, okay. Oh yeah, this plane does fly a bit different now. You can see it's tilting. Aha! And that way we're able to gain proper speed now, finally. The 777X is happy. Are we going to ignore that? Yes. Are we gonna land the 777 on a short runway? Yes, of course we are too. So come on, let's maybe go ahead and just put the wing sweep up here. Yeah, check this out. I like the animation. That's like the only good thing that this plane has. Other than that, it's definitely incomplete, but oh yeah, okay. Now this is a proper flight test. Come on, let's maybe go ahead and establish a little bit of a slow flight, bit of a critical flight too here. Trying to land now. 170 knots. Okay, that looks interesting. Oh, we've got a stall warning. The flaps are, by the way, at 100%. Mm-hmm. The plane doesn't like to be flown that way. All right, there you go. Come on, let's land here on this relatively short runway there. Oh, that was a hard landing. Come on, it's time to stop. Now, that's kind of worked, though. Come on, full power into the reverse thrust. I really have lots of trust in the thrust of the G9X. Oh, we're not stopping, are we? Okay. I mean, that's got nothing to do with the wingtips here. But this is very interesting. The plane is not that much of a short runway lander. That test is absolutely unnecessary. There we go. Yeah, okay. Boom. Looking great. You know, I definitely have lots of respect for the engineering that goes behind designing these wingtips right here. I mean, after all, that's just a moving part in a plane, and that's always something that, you know, can pose a danger to not work, for example. I mean, what happens if the wingtip gets stuck? Okay, you know, in midair, this won't be a big danger because, I mean, if it gets to be stuck in the normal position, that's no problem. But, like, maybe on the ground or something. I mean, this is volatile and stuff. Definitely part of the reason why it took so long now to certify this plane and is still doing. Is it worth it though? Yes, of course it is. I mean, after all, we're looking at this very huge long wing that has very good lift to drag ratio, increased from 9-to-1 to 10-to-1. This all makes the plane very efficient. Together with the engine here, we should improve fuel consumption by 10%. That's really good. Also the wings, again, 7% improvement. This is gonna be a big hit. Will this plane be safer flying to huge storms and turbulence than like a 787 or something? Definitely not. I mean, just structurally, again, we have this breaking point here. Actually, that's nicely animated here, the wing flex two of this plane. You can see it nicely flexing around. We probably shouldn't put out the wing sweeps now, but we can do that anyway. Yeah, there we go. Check this out. Looking great. Yes, just physically, this will have a structural limit, but still, we're probably talking about still a masterpiece of engineering. This won't happen. This plane won't fall apart in midair. Oh, God. Come on. Let me not die now. Now, proper landing on the 777X. We have got reduced control here now. Plane doesn't fly too well. Even though I reckon with a wing sweep, this plane would control a little bit better now. Anyway, come on. All right, there we go. We've touched down. Okay, come on, stop now. You can do it. You can do it. It won't stop. It won't stop. We're literally dying. Okay, this is not a great stopper. You know, I would like to kind of do a good landing here with this plane once in this video. Because, I mean, again, it's looking relatively promising. Look at the wing. All right, come on now. Coming in for an airbase. Okay, we crashed into some trees. Now with the proper wings here. This is how this plane is meant to be flown. So let's go ahead and try this now. Alright, that's been still a hard landing. But we don't worry about that. Let's go ahead and now stop here. Looking great. I think very straightforward. Can nicely stop here with the 777. The new 777X has landed beautifully. Might have been a bit hard, but there we go. We did it. The biggest 777 ever has landed. So we're at the 777X here now, coming in for a beautiful landing. A bit better of a landing than the one I did. Yeah, kind of buttery too. And then on the runway here, putting the wing sweep. I mean, just that. That is so nice. Everybody, this is promising new technology that maybe is coming in a couple of years. And a very smart idea, I think. So, thank you guys so much for watching today's video. And I'll see you guys tomorrow, as always. Good night. Now, thank you very much to my highly supporting members like Jamie Ashton, Mike C, James Durham, Ragings, MetRLG, Matt Van Z, Moritz, Bellhausen, Knots Enthusiast, Shadow, New The York, Ryland Williams, Kelly Chaos, John O'Brien, and I'm addicted to Airbus A380s. Thank you.